Time now for everybody's favorite guessing game, What's My Line? Throughout the world, only one company produces all types of business machines and systems, Remington Rand, who now invites you to play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television who just returned to us from Florida, Miss Arlene Francis.
And tonight, substituting for our missing Bennett, sir, is a charmer who, with his doll of a wife, will be present at the world premiere of their new picture, Forever Darling, in Jamestown, New York, on Tuesday night. But tonight, fortunately, he is with us, Desi Arnaz.
And to my left, ladies and gentlemen, a very lovely and charming young lady who's one of my favorite columnists and whom I had the pleasure of knowing for many years, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Me escuerda el señor Vertigo Allen.
Wow.
What do you know? What do you
know? That man you introduced, Dorothy, couldn't come tonight. ladies and gentlemen, if this show was Zoo Parade, I might be here introducing a buck-tooth razorback hog. But since this is What's My Line, I am here on purpose to introduce our moderator, super sly John Daly.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. And panel, I've got the best possible news for you. Please get your blindfolds on.
Oh,
that's too bad, isn't it? Well, we're going to play some tricks tonight. And while we play some tricks, we've got some very interesting people with some very interesting occupations who will, I think, give the panel a lot of trouble. We'll also have a famous guest challenger a bit later on. And when we get all the blindfolds on, we will produce an individual who, panel, of course, has some area of identification which we feel that we must hide from you because either in appearance, costuming, handwriting, or some other aspect of personal character would give you too much information. Are the blindfolds all in place now?
Yes, Mr. Daly.
Well, good. Will our first challenger come in and sign in, please? Now, panel, needless to say, I can't tell you what our guest's name is because there again we might tell you too much. So I will ask our guest, first of all, if he is familiar with our scoring operation. Are you?
Yep.
Well, if you're familiar with the scoring operation, let's let our friends here in the theater, the folks who are at home, know exactly what your line is. Panel, just to be sure that we keep everything in balance and that you get a little bit of help, I will tell you that our guest is self-employed. With that, let's begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Do you work for... Oh, no, you don't. You're self-employed.
Yes.
Oh. Do you deal in services rather than a product?
Yep.
Are your services such that they would bring you to the attention of the general public?
Are your services such that they would bring you to the attention of the general public?
Yep.
Does your picture ever appear in the newspapers?
Yep.
When you're doing whatever it is that you do, do people watch you?
Not often.
But I would say that there is an occasion when that might be true, Miss Kilgallen, so you continue.
Do you have an office of sorts?
Do you have an office of sorts?
Nope.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Allen.
Well, if you're self-employed and you have no office, where do you do your business?
That, Mr. Allen. Now, this is not to say that our guest might not on occasion work in an office, but equally he might work elsewhere, so that the question is answered correctly when we say there is not a specific office to which he must repair.
Well, would we know him by sight, this gentleman, if we weren't blindfolded? Do you think we would know him by sight?
I would say, Fred, if our guest will permit me to answer, that that is likely.
Is he in the political field?
Only loosely.
Lucy. Well, that
is that he's in it with Lucy?
No. I said loosely.
Oh, loosely. Oh,
that's
you heard me the first time.
That's another show. I love loosely. That's Well, you're not in the am I still on, John?
Yeah, you're still on.
I can't see what I'm doing here.
Dark in here.
You're not in the political field, then?
Well, actually, the question was answered, Fred, that you might consider that under certain circumstances and in another time or again in some future time, we would consider that our guest has had some connection with the political field.
John,
I'm not a candidate of this campaign.
A candidate of this campaign?
No, I'm not.
You're not a candidate?
No, sir.
I heard that the groundhog came out and saw three shadows and went back in again. Mr. Stevenson, Keith Alver, and the other gentleman. Are you a politician?
Nope.
That makes it two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
One detects that your accent is not purely American. Is it possible that you come from another country?
Yep.
Is the other country England?
Yep.
Swell. you're not a politician and you're from England? Heaven.
well, a conference?
Are you... Yes.
You may have 15 seconds for a conference.
Well, I was just thinking that there was a politer word for it, diplomat.
Yeah.
Nope. No, that wasn't a question formally posed. The conference time is now over. Miss Francis, will you continue?
Are you a diplomat?
Nope.
That's three down and
thank
five.
Thank you, Dorothy Kilgallen.
Desi Arnaz.
You know, I have a lot of trouble speaking English with my eyes open. This, I don't know if I'm going to be able to. This is pretty rough. He's not a diplomat, eh? He's from England. Let me say,
Every Englishman is a diplomat, so I don't believe that statement.
Yeah, are you, in the literary world? Are you a writer of America?
Yep.
You are.
All right, Desi, now. Desi?
Yes,
you got
John.
It. Now, what are you going to do with it?
Well, now, let me see. Do you write mostly just for, for books, or you also write for the screen?
Now, that, you want to break that up into two nice questions, which can be answered yes, and I watch your step, because I think everybody should know, by the way, that Miss Lucy is over in Grand Central Station watching the program on a television set because they're both going to Jamestown for the opening of the new picture.
Yeah, but she's not helping me any over there now, Mark.
I think the television set left on track five.
What was the answer to that question, John?
It was a two-part question, Desi. If you'll break it down into two questions, would you like to ask the specific question, does our guest write books?
Yeah, yes.
Yep.
He writes books. Have any of your books ever been made into a motion picture?
Nope.
That's good. Go ahead, Doug.
What on Miss Kilgallen?
Are you noted for your works of nonfiction rather than fiction? And I have a feeling I've asked that wrong.
Nope.
That makes it,
it's more fictional.
Let me have a small conference.
More fiction than nonfiction.
I know, Shakespeare.
Would you ask that question again, Miss Dorothy?
You mean the way I asked it before?
Yeah.
Well, what I asked was, are you more famous for your works of nonfiction than for your fiction?
Yep.
Oh.
Nonfiction.
Oh, Lord.
Do you, by any chance, dabble in poetry?
Nope.
That makes it $5.05 to go, Mr. Allen.
Do you have a famous father?
Yep.
Are you yep. Mr. Randolph Churchill?
Yep.
Yep. Very good going, Fred. Actually, I must say that Mr. Churchill was a bit surprised after he gave an answer of more than a monosyllable that it didn't come up sooner, but I thought you did very well disguising your voice.
Well, I met Mr. Churchill. He may not remember it. Nobody remembers when they've met me. But when we were in London with Tallulah 3 or 4 years ago.
I remember very well.
And I met you there.
I wouldn't forget anything like that.
And as it went around,
I couldn't see you through the mask.
Your voice. Well, I wasn't talking with my eyes. My pupils were sitting down at the moment.
Well, sir, your great father has done us much honor on many public occasions by referring to the fact that your grandmother was an American, and we kind of think that you are, in a way, American, too.
Well, I'm afraid I'm only a 25% American.
25% American. Are you going to stay in the United States for a bit?
Not very long. I'm flying down on Tuesday to South Carolina to see Mr. Bernard M. Baruch. I rather want to know what's going on in this country, and I find he usually has some clues. And I'm coming back and going back to England on flying back to England on Friday.
Well, it's very nice of you to have taken some time out to spend with us. Thanks.
Well, thank
it's been good
so
to
much.
Have you on. Well, a very good beginning. Now let's see
you
if we can.
You accuse me of knowing all the time, John.
Well, actually,
you're from my lawyer.
You're from Boston, which is the next thing to being British anyway, you know.
That's right. I guessed Mr. Lodge the other day, too.
You guessed Mr. Lodge, too.
I guess that's my field, John.
I think that is, Fred. You just read so widely, you know?
Yes, I do.
Well, we've got one for
you. Cinerama reader. I read widely.
You read widely. Let's see what you can do with another challenger now, Mr. Allen. You're
I'm through for the night.
You're through for the night. Will you sign in, please, sir? Floyd? Carlson, is that right, sir?
From? Richland Hills, Texas.
Richland Hills, Texas. Well, it's nice to have a Texan with us. And actually, we're a little bit short of time tonight, you know. I think if you don't mind, you take a look at the panel. Then you come with me. We won't give them any more clues, eh? And tell me if you know how we score this operation, do you?
Yes, I do.
You do know how we score it? Then let's let the folks at home and our friends here know exactly what your line is. Panel, once again, to be as helpful as we can, I will tell you that Mr. Carlson is salaried. And let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Carlson, do you deal in services?
Yes, I do.
Are they beneficial for both men and women?
Yes.
Do they come to you, these men and women?
Yes.
Do you work indoors?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Arnaz.
I don't work indoors.
Nobody in Texas works indoors.
I guess so.
Not in Texas.
Wide open spaces. I'm going to be in Texas next week. Maybe I'll come to you for one of these services, if you could tell me.
I hope it'll be nice.
Yeah. If I went to you for one of this, would I feel better after I got through with it?
Yes.
I would feel better?
I would think so, Desi. I think it's fair and safe to say that if you were to call on Mr. Carlson for his services, you'd feel pleased about having had them.
Uh-huh. If I went there, would you touch me in any way when you're doing this thing?
No, I wouldn't think it was necessary. No, I mean, that I will admit, Desi, that it's possible, as is true in all these cases, there might be some physical contact, but it's not...
He works by long distance. Yes,
yeah, bruh. That's 2 down and 8 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Mr. Carlson, could I enjoy your services as well as Desi?
Yes.
Oh, he's got quite a racket as well.
Outdoors.
And we would be out of doors whenever we negotiated whatever this is?
Yes.
What part of Texas did you say you were from?
Richland Hills.
Where's that near?
Not Texas.
No clue.
Do you ever work with animals?
No. 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Allen.
You confine all of your activities to human beings, do you?
Yes.
And do you... See, Desi put it out of my mind. I was going to ask you something. But I... you work out of doors. Is there a product involved in what you do? Of any sort?
No, not...
No.
Actually, there is, as is often the case, but a product... you know, in the area, but the basically our friend Mr. Carlson deals in services. He does
uh-huh.
not convey or purvey a product of any kind.
Good.
Yeah. That's 4 down and 6 to go, Miss Francis.
Mr. Carlson, since you work out of doors, does locomotion have anything to do with your job?
Yes.
Do you, in carrying on your work, go from one place to another?
Yes.
Do you go from one place to another, in the air?
Yes.
Jolly good. Then you are in some method of transportation that flies. Is it something that is not usually used in the air? I mean, is it unlike an airplane, for example, that is average? Everybody uses those. Do you have some other mode of transportation in the air other than an airplane?
You mean a standard commercial airliner?
All right, John, yes.
That's fine. Yeah, your answer would be yes.
Yes.
Would it be a form of locomotion such as a helicopter?
Yes.
It's a whirlybird. Don't call it a helicopter. Whirlybird.
I was in one down in Tampa. That's what made me think of it. Do you operate a helicopter line?
Yes. Yeah. And, Mr. Arnaz, I want you to meet Mr. Carlson because he's going to be at Jamestown tomorrow to fly you and Miss Lucy to your...
Oh!
And actually,
you better go
get
some rest, huh?
You better go home and get some rest. Actually, Mr. Carlson, and by the way, I think statistics are very interesting in this degree. He's one of the test pilots for Bell Aircraft, but this is the third man in the United States to get a helicopter license.
Lovely.
Mr. Carlson, thanks very much. You gave him a rough time. It was nice to have you with us to watch my life. And now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which my friends on the panel are once again blindfolded. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, Mr. Daly.
Yes, senor.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, we go to a different form of questioning. You may ask one question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise. And we'll begin it all with Fred Allen.
I assume that this is a lady, John, because of the whistling and the vociferous reaction of the audience.
The assumption is a reasonable one.
Are you in the theatrical business, miss or madam or missus?
Yeah, I guess so.
Pardon?
You got a yes, I guess, sir. Miss
yes,
Francis?
Sir?
Mm-hmm.
Have you appeared in pictures?
I'd say so, ma'am.
It's Randolph Churchill back.
Desi Arnaz?
Why didn't you get somebody over here today that I can understand?
I can't understand you, sir.
Oh, I like her. Appearing on television? Have you appeared on television besides right now? I mean...
Oh, I've been on a few times, yes, sir.
Miss Kilgallen?
Have you appeared in the Broadway theater?
No, I haven't.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Allen.
You haven't been in the theater? Are you on a television show currently? I mean, a show of your own, a weekly show.
No.
That's two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Would you be considered a leading lady?
I don't know.
I would.
John?
Yes, I would think is the answer to that, Miss Arlene. Mr. Arnaz?
Well, now, let's see. Are you known more for your dramatic roles than anything else? I mean, would you be known more for dramatic than for comedy roles?
I like to think so, sir.
Miss Kilgallen?
What was that? Yes.
Dramatic more than comedy.
Have you made a picture which is planning to be shown, or which they are planning to show at Radio City Music Hall?
Yes.
Mr. Allen?
Is that all I have to know now, is what's coming to the music hall the next?
All you have to know, Fred, actually, is what's coming to the music hall in the next 10 years, and you're in.
I did know, John, but it's escaped my... I pass.
Is the picture that's coming to the music hall a picnic?
That's right. That's what I'm...
What did
it
you
is
say?
Picnic?
Is the picture coming a picnic?
Well, it
That's
is a picnic.
Right.
I've seen it previewed, and it's just wonderful. Are you the young lady that plays the lead in Picnic?
Yes.
Kim Novak?
Kim Novak? Oh, well, that's easy. We'll kick it over. Where do you want it to go? There, you name it. No, actually, I must say, Miss Kim, you did a very good job with that English accent. But I'm afraid that the wolf calls and the whistles, which, though we shouldn't at my age talk about these things, are well-deserved, kind of gave things away, and that tipped the panel off. But a very good English accent, I think. Fred?
That pass that I gave John is not good to get in the theater. I mean, when Picnic opens, you can't get in there. With Have you heard that the American Tobacco Company is going to put a filter on Old Smokey? Have you heard that? Might as well change the subject.
No, we had
Picnic. I saw the play. Miss Novak wasn't in the play.
Well, the picture is wonderful, and you're charming in it, Miss Novak.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm glad you gave the plug for us, Dorothy.
But you're a blonde now, and you're a redhead in the picture. I've seen a preview, too. What happened?
Oh. Well, my hair has been blonde always, except for a picnic. Josh Logan thought it would be more in character of a Kansas girl. So I put on a long red ball.
Well, you look beautiful.
Our very good friend, Mr. Holden, is in the picture. He does a wonderful job. We had a lot of fun
Ross
doing
Russell.
A TV show with Bill a couple of years ago, when he wound up with a face full of pie and all that stuff. You know?
Oh, I saw that.
Well, actually, I don't want you to wind up with a face full of pie. We're not no plans for that tonight. We want to thank you very much for being our guest. And a prettier one we haven't had in many a moon. Thanks a lot
Thank
for
you.
Being with us. Nice to see you. I would make one note for the record, if I may. This is by way of being our sixth anniversary. The actual date was February 2nd, and we've had a lot of nice telegrams from Frank Stanton, who's the head of CBS, and our old colleague, Mr. Block. And we're kind of happy about the anniversary and would like to, if we may, digress from good manners long enough for me to wish the panel many happy returns. Before the panel says good night, may I remind you to tune in again next week at 10:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, when once again we invite you to play What's My Line? For other localities, check your local listings for the date and the time of our weekly series. And now a word from next week's sponsor. And now for a personal message, Miss Lucy. Desi did real good, and we're proud of him. He did real good.
You,
until next week, this is John Daly saying good night, Miss Arlene.
Good night, and good night, Desi. And you have to get ready now to run to meet Lucy and the train. It was
good
fun
night,
having
dear.
You with us.
Good night, Dorothy.
Good night, Desi. Thanks for every sin. Bye, Lucy. Adios, friend.
Good night, John.
Good night, Mr. Allen.
Did you hear about the boy who won the $100,000 in the big surprise? They just caught him this afternoon. His father, he got away with the money. He bought five Fanny Farmer candy stores before he...
Good night, Fred, and good night, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for being with us on What's My Line?
Travel arrangements on What's My Line are made through American Airlines. American Airlines flies our contestants in luxurious comfort aboard DC-7 flagships. This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production, in association with the CBS Television Network.